We now continue with more of The Mark Milton Show with The Smash on 590 The Fan and 590thefan.com. Oh, life
is bigger. Good tune. It's bigger than you. That is a good tune. You are not me. He just turned, Michael Stipe. Just turned about 65 years old.
Who's like that? R.E.M.?
Yeah.
You know all these guys. I don't know any of these names.
Michael Stipe, man.
I just know R.E.M.
The leader of R.E.M.
I just know the name.
One of the geniuses of the music business. Here we go. I set it up. That's me in the corner. Man, what a good song. That's me in the spot.
Life. Losing my religion. You know what? This is the Mark Milton Show. With the Smash, broadcasting from the Miller Furniture Studios here in Kirkwood. Smash, losing our religion. I feel like that's a poignant...
Can I stop you right
sure.
now?
Sure.
I heard me and you singing right there together. We could have been 2/5 of the Osmond Brothers, man. We could have.
I've seen the Osmond Brothers and the Lennon Sisters perform at Branson.
They're fantastic, aren't they?
They're okay.
I'm trying to be positive.
Donnie is tremendous. The others, not so much.
Really?
This is the Mark Milton Show with the Smash, broadcasting okay. from the Miller Furniture Studios. Want to give a shout-out to our sponsor, First Bank, Andy Newbold, First Bank Mortgage, for all your mortgage needs.
Nice.
I refinanced through First Bank, I guess it was towards the end of the year.
Yeah.
I've done several mortgages over the years, refinances. It was the best experience I ever had.
Yeah.
So I would encourage all of our listeners to give Andy Newbold, First Bank, a shout-out at your mortgage business if you're looking for a new house.
Yeah.
Or if you're looking to refi. It's a great opportunity to refi right now with rates being about as low as they've ever been in the history of our country. So you can check out Andy Newbold. You can give him shoot him an email. It's andy.newbold@fbol.com. Again, it's andy.newbold@fbol.com. Or you can call him. Here's his cell number, 314-660-2223 for all of your mortgage needs.
All right. Let's say he's my mortgage guy.
Sure.
You're my tax guy. I'm 71 years old. Should I get a 30-year fixed rate, or would it be better for me to just maybe get underneath the mattress and pull out all my money?
Well, so a 30-year is obviously going to have a higher rate than a shorter term, right? Uh-huh.
But I ain't got all that much time left to live.
I don't want to go there with these. But I'm saying you're going to have to pay more per month if you have a, you know, shorter
a
term, a 15. Well, no, I'm saying if you get a 15-year versus
right.
a 30-year, I mean, you're going to have a higher
payment.
That's
what payment. I'm thinking.
Better
but
go 30. But what you could always do is if you have a 30-year, you could always apply – you can make earlier payments yes. on the principal
yes.
to knock down the principal. You can do that.
Yeah.
And also another tip out there, it's kind of a tax tip. If you've got other debt, you know, if you got credit card debt, other things out there.
You are the STL tax lawyer.
But if you're sitting on a lot of equity,
yeah.
it's a really good idea to consider refinancing because that mortgage interest becomes deductible on your taxes.
Oh, really?
So rather than paying, you know, high, and the interest rates are crazy on a credit card.
Yeah,
so it's a really
right.
good idea to consider looking at a refinance, you know, cash out refinance uh-huh. where you can take some money out and pay off your debt. Or let's say you got some equity in your house and you're looking to do, maybe say you want to get a new patio.
Yes.
You want to give our guys at TRC Outdoor a call.
Like your patio.
And get a new patio or do some new landscaping. You could also do a cash out refinance to pay for a new project, mm-hmm. a new project through TRC Outdoor. Mm-hmm. And we hope you would consider giving TRC Outdoor an opportunity at your outdoor landscaping needs.
If I wanted to talk to them about a patio, you know where I'd take them?
TRCOutdoor.com.
Patios.
Patios downtown. Go
talk
hang
it
out
up
though.
Right there, buddy.
Talk them up. TRCOutdoor.com.
They did a job on your place,
they
man.
Did. It's
that
phenomenal.
Beautiful.
They did tremendous work.
Beautiful.
The whole backyard
yep.
totally rejuvenated. So be sure for all your landscaping needs, hardscape, mm-hmm. Whatever you need outdoors, give TRC Outdoor a call. You can check them out at trcoutdoor.com. Smash, losing our religion. Mm. I think that's an interesting song to come back to because mm. one of the things that struck me over the holiday season was I did get to go to church on Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
And it was very, not to get sentimental or cheesy, but I do feel like this last year, our country kind of drifted away from believing in something bigger than ourselves. It's sort
right.
of, we got consumed by COVID. There's a lot of fear. And not a lot of hope. And so I was hopeful for the new year that we'd have, you know, kind of a return to believing in something bigger than ourselves, getting over the fears.
Can you
of
not just say believing in God instead of something
believing
bigger
in God,
than ourselves?
Yeah, I believe in God, okay?
That's what they always Christian. Say, believe in something bigger
no,
than
I'm
ourselves.
No, I'm just saying I believe in God,
God,
and I think that our country in a lot of ways has lost its way because we've lost that belief in God. I think
yeah.
a lot of people don't believe, and
yep.
I think that And that's fine if you don't. But I guess what I'm saying, when I say believe in something bigger than yourselves, I think that's what the Christmas season is to me, is like believing in hope that, you know, Jesus
that's
is God's
bigger.
Son.
Okay, I got you.
And I know you're a firm believer. I mean, you grew up Jewish, and now you're Christian now. Is that right?
I don't want to talk about it.
You don't want to talk about it? But, I mean, what does it mean to you? I mean, what does God mean to you in your life?
When I was a kid, I was brought up with two religions, all right? My father's Jewish Greek, and my mom's a Greek Orthodox. So I go to temple with my dad, and I went to church with my mom. Growing up in either of those communities, the Jewish kids didn't take to me because my Jewish father married a Christian woman. The Christian side didn't take to me because my Christian mom was married to a Jew. And so I had a dichotomy going that's kind of like the divide of this country. And in that dichotomy, when I got older and I didn't have to go to temple with Pop anymore, I didn't go to church or temple after that for the longest time. And then it came time. I wind up having kids. And I'm thinking to myself, well, I grew up in the Jewish community because Mom and Pop worked real hard to get me that membership at the Jewish Community Center in Indianapolis so I could go to the teen canteen and, you know, play pool and the swimming pool and everything.
I used to hoop at the JCC in D.C.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
So anyway, those kids treated me so, and I guess, Dave, you can edit this, but they treated me so shittily. I said to myself, well, I don't want none of this. And then on the other side, I had some shitty treatment from the Greeks. And I'm thinking, you know, I don't want this to happen for my kids. All right. I grew out of it. I'm a young adult. I don't want this to happen for my kids. So I had to make a decision. I had married a Christian girl. And my decision was I'm going to bring my kids up Christian. And my decision was that I do believe that the Lord sent his son to help redeem us. That's my belief. All right. That's not my think so. That's not my, boy, I wish I could study some more. That's my belief. I've read the Bible 5, maybe 6 times in its entirety. And excerpts from the Bible, I do a show called The People's Praise Party. And that's the show plays on another radio station. And it's a rocking music show. But I put my testimony in there, too. My testimony is I believe that the Lord sent his son. His son was named Jesus. And that Jesus is the Son of God. And that's the way I'm going to go. And I'm the example for my kids. I don't have a double whammy going, and they have to make their decisions and everything. And I don't know how it is nowadays with the kids, but the brutality that I had to deal with between the Jewish Community Center kids and the Greek church kids, I didn't want to see that for my children. So I decided, yeah, you know, I do believe in God. I believed of Jesus for the longest time, but I never believed in Jesus. And I know through the debacle that's been this last 10 years of me losing work, me losing all my stocks and bonds and all the money that I had, and then me losing my wife, I thought to myself, man, the only thing that's kept me sane and not killing somebody was my belief in the Lord.
That's powerful stuff. And we need redemption right now. I think our nation needs redemption. We need, you know, like I said, a belief in something bigger. And I've always been very faithful. I feel like it's been a big part of my life, just believing in God, believing in Jesus. But I think no matter what you believe in, it's just, it's good to have, you know, not be so, like, I think some of the left politicians, I mean, they believe so much in the state, right?
Yeah.
And the government being the end-all, be-all. And I hope that this year we can get back to believing in something more than, you know, dependence on government and believing in hope, and that things can get better, that we can get along, that we don't have to fight about all these issues, that we can somehow find the good in people, find the good in everything, and hopefully that's what 21 will be for us.
I certainly hope so. I tell you what, I've run across folks who come to me and say, how could you have turned your back on your religion, meaning Judaism? And I said, I didn't turn my back on the religion. Judaism is a part of Christianity.
Well, our country was built on Judeo-Christian values.
Exactly right. That's what, more or less what I was going to get to. But the main thing is I did not turn my back on my heritage. And my heritage is I'm a Greek Jew, born of Greek Jews.
And you believe in the Judeo-Christian values.
Exactly.
And again, that's what that's treat everybody like you want to be treated. Right, I mean, the golden rule. That's
Merry Christmas next year in case I don't see
you. We need to get back to, as a society, the golden rule. Let's just be nicer, kinder, gentler to each other, and have a better 2021 for all. You're listening to the Mark Milton Show. That took a weird twist on the religious stuff, but sometimes
yeah, you brought it up, man. I said I didn't want to talk about it.
So you're listening to the Mark Milton Show with the Smash, broadcasting from the Miller Furniture Studios,
yep,
and presented by STLTaxLawyer.com. Remember, the choice of a lawyer is an important decision and should not be based solely on advertisements. You can find us every week on 590 The Fan, 590TheFan.com. You can download our podcast at Apple iTunes, anywhere you subscribe to podcasts. We appreciate you listening and wish you a great 2021, and yep, certainly a lot better than 2020.
Yep.